Let us get this camera.
If your form is compromised, the weight is too heavy. For me personally, the hip thrust is one of, if not the best glute exercise.
Hey guys, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're new here, then hi, my name is Liz Kerry. I'm a doctor working in the UK. I'm also a tutor and educator, as well as an online coach, and I share everything faith, medicine, and fitness related. If you're not new here, then thank you so much for joining back in. Please make sure you hit the subscribe button and you switch on the notifications so you don't miss any of my videos. In today's video, we're going to be talking about all things booty, glutes, backside, ASS, dump truck, I don't know, basically all the things behind. If you are a gym girly trying to grow your glutes, whether you're a beginner or you've been in the gym for years, hopefully this video will be useful for you. So for a bit of context, I'm just going to give you guys a bit of background as to where I am currently in my fitness journey. So I've currently been training for the last six-ish, seven-ish years, I'd say six-ish years. When you think about all the breaks and all the periods where I wasn't training, I'd say 6 years. And I'm currently at a stage of my fitness journey where my primary focus and goal is body recomposition. So my main three goals at the moment is losing body fat, gaining and maintaining muscle, as well as gaining and maintaining strength. So I've been on this journey for the last 6 to 8 weeks, seeing my body change tremendously in the past. You know, I've seen myself be a lot leaner than I am. I've seen myself be a lot bigger than I am. Like, I've literally been on both ends of the spectrum. I've been underweight, I've been overweight, I've been lean, I haven't been lean. Like, I've seen my body in so many different shapes and sizes. It's crazy. For me right now, my goal is prioritizing, you know, lifting heavy, moving my body often, getting my cardio in, and eating good nutritious meals. Actually looking at some pictures from myself like a few months ago, as well as a picture of myself like this time last year in my old like flat. I was looking at them, I was like, wow, like, pat yourself on the back, Liz, like, you've been putting in the work. And for me, it was nice to see that whilst yes, I am losing fat, my glutes and even my hamstrings and my quads, but my glutes are, if anything, bigger and more plump and more like lifted. And I know that there's probably a lot of girls that, if you ask any fitness girl what their goal is, they're gonna say, I want a big booty, I want a slim waist, and da-da-da. I thought it would be nice for me to share the tips that I found that have helped me lose fat and lose weight, but at the same time, like, build my glutes and maintain my glutes. So when it comes to transforming or changing your physique, this is gonna be down to two very big things: how you train and how you eat. When it comes to how you train, I'm gonna break this down into three sections: the frequency of your training, that specific muscle group, so in this example, glutes, the exercises that you're using to train, and the training techniques that you're using, because obviously you can do an exercise and use different training techniques and bring them together. So it's not just the exercises you're doing, it's how you're using them and the training techniques that you're using with those exercises. So looking at the frequency that you train, if you are trying to put size on your glutes, if you're trying to grow your glutes or keep them toned and defined, especially if you're eating in a calorific deficit or you are cutting or you're trying to lose fat, it's very, very important to make sure that you're training your glutes regularly. Guys, you really have to bear in mind, when it comes to do with anything lower body, so glutes, hamstrings, and quads, these are some of the biggest muscles in your body. Your glutes, or the gluteus maximus, is the largest muscle in the body, so you need to be training it often. If you're training your glutes once a week, you're just not going to see the results, because that's not enough load or tension for the biggest muscle in your body. Like, when you're doing anything to do with legs, you have to think about the size of the muscles in your legs, your glutes, your hamstrings, your quads. These are some large muscles, so you need to be loading them consistently. So I'd personally say, if you're trying to grow your glutes and you're serious about it, I would aim to train your glutes twice a week. I personally train my glutes twice a week. So I do a glute session on Monday, and then on Friday I do a glutes and hamstring session, but that glutes and hamstring session is still like 75% glutes. So I train my glutes twice a week, and I feel like doing it on a Monday and a Friday gives me enough time to recover, and it gives me enough time in between for me to make sure that by Friday I'm feeling good to go and hit another glute session. There's no point overtraining your glutes, there's no point training your glutes every day, that's just way too much load. But I'd say 2 to 3 times a week is great. Even if you do 2 focus days, and then on one of the other lower body days or one of your other training days, you add like one exercise or two
exercises of glutes into it. It could be a good like compromise or medium you can come to. So I'd say anywhere between 2 to 3 times a week is excellent for glute growth. When it comes to exercises, you need to differentiate between compound movements and then accessory or isolation movements. Now, in reality, there is no exercise that completely will isolate only one muscle. There will always be multiple muscles being used to stabilize the joint or being used to, you know, support the joint and to support the movement. Even lateral raises, you're not just using your deltoids or your lateral deltoids, you're also using your traps, you're also using your rotator cuffs to help stabilize the shoulder joint. So whilst there are exercises that can isolate or greater isolate, there is no just one exercise that just focuses on the glute, especially because your glute muscles are part of your posterior chain. So your posterior chain is literally all the muscles at the posterior of you or the back of you. So your back, your glutes and your hamstrings all make up your posterior chain. So you'll find that a lot of glute exercises use a lot of the posterior chain. Like when you're doing RDLs, the whole posterior chain is being used. When you're doing hip thrusts, glutes, hamstrings, when you're doing kickbacks, glute, hamstrings, a little bit of your lower back. Like, it's really hard to find only one exercise that will just focus on the glutes. But like I said, there are definitely exercises that allow greater focus. So for me personally, I would put hip thrusts and RDLs or any kind of deadlift variation into your compound exercises. And then your accessory or isolation exercises will be things like kickbacks, hip abductors, step ups, Bulgarian split squats, glute hyperextensions. So I would actually put sumo squats in the compound movement as well. Yeah, I'd put sumo squats there. All those kind of, you know, kickback, glute isolation kind of exercises would go in the accessory isolations category. So your hip thrust, for me personally, the hip thrust is one of, if not the best glute exercise in my opinion, I think. And the reason why I say that is because it's the exercise you can load on the most. It's great for progressive overload. It's great because it really does, even though it's a compound movement, you can really isolate and feel that contraction and burn in your glutes. And like I said, there's so many different variations. So you can do just a normal standard barbell hip thrust. As you guys can hopefully see, the key things when it comes to a barbell hip thrust is making sure the movement is slow and controlled. You want proper form. You should be taking your time to lower the weight, get that good stretch in the glutes, and then squeeze upwards, hold at the top for maybe 1 to 2 seconds, and then lower the weight down. I don't swing the weight. I don't use momentum. I'm not flinging the weight up and down. I make sure, regardless of how much I'm lifting, my sets at 100 kg and 220 kg look exactly the same. If your form is compromised, the weight is too heavy, please. It's really as simple as that. So that is the standard like barbell hip thrust, but you can do hip thrust with a heavy dumbbell. You can do single leg hip thrust. You can do B stance hip thrust, which is where you have one leg out and one leg closer, and you're basically working the glute of the leg that is closer to you. I just love hip thrust. I think they're a very versatile exercise. And I think, like I said, it's great for loading your glutes and really providing that tension on the glute muscles. I do believe every single glute workout you do should have some form of a hip thrust. I personally will hip thrust on both my glute days. The weight I do and the reps and sets will differ, and I'll talk more on that when I talk about the training techniques that I use and that I would suggest that you use. But I do hip thrust twice a week, and every time that I do hip thrust, I will superset it with some kind of glute bridge movement. So I'll do like my barbell hip thrust, I'll get my glute band, and then I'll do some kind of glute bridge, or I'll do like staggered hip thrust, or I'll do single leg hip thrust. I always superset it with something, and I just like doing that because the burn is crazy. Like, honestly, after you get to 5 sets of doing like 10 barbell hip thrusts and then 10 supersetting it with 10 single leg hip thrusts, the burn after is phenomenal. So that's the way I like to do it. I personally just like a good old barbell, slap the plates on, and I'm good to go. But I know some people like Smith machine, they like the hip thrust like actual machine. That's just me. I like the good old fashioned pick up the weights, pick up the barbell, we good. The second compound movement is an RDL, which is a Romanian deadlift, or any kind of deadlift variation. So whether you want to do sumo, stiff leg, RDL, or conventional, I think all are really good for the glutes. Obviously the RDL is really going to isolate and focus on the glutes. Your stiff leg will more be for your hamstrings. Your conventional will more be for like your overall body as well as your posterior chain. I personally RDL once a week. Key things with this movement is that it's a hip hinge movement, meaning that you basically want to be pushing your glutes back, slight bend in the knees. And the way that I think about it is you want to keep the bar as close to your legs as possible. Try and think of it as you're using the bar to wipe down the front of your legs. So you really want to keep that bar close to yourself, pushing your hips back, making sure that your neck is in line with your back. I see a lot of people doing deadlifts and they're looking up when they're lowering the weight. If you do that, you're going to have a kink in your back because your back is going to be like this and your neck is going to be like this because you're looking up. You want your neck to be in line with your back. So if you are lowering the weight, your gaze is going to drop, and as you're bringing the weight back up, your gaze is going to come back up. You want your neck to be in line with your back. This prevents injury. This will protect your cervical spine. You really don't want to be kinking and bending and hyperextending your neck. It's not safe. It can cause injuries, so really make sure that your neck stays in line with your back. Would encourage you guys also to RDL once a week. I think once a week is definitely enough because you have to remember an RDL is a very, very taxing exercise. It puts a lot of pressure and stress on your back, especially your lower back, especially for someone like me that goes super heavy. Allow your neuromuscular system to have some time to rest. I feel like the RDL is a very, very strenuous exercise on the posterior chain, so I personally feel like RDL and once a week is fine. But if you do want to RDL twice a week, I would say do one that is maybe heavier with a barbell and stuff like that, and then you can go a bit lighter with just a dumbbell and focusing more on form and time under tension. I would say yeah, maybe you can RDL twice a week, but I only RDL once a week. Final compound movement is a sumo squat. The reason why I'm putting it in a compound movement is because it's really just a lower body movement. Of course, you can focus more on your glutes with how you set up your stance and things like that, but a sumo squat will always work your quads, your glutes, and your hamstrings, so I'm gonna put it in the compound movement section. The way that I've been able to really focus and target my glutes with a sumo squat is by hinging at the hips before I lower down into my squat. So if I can find a video of me doing this hinging movement, I will include it here. But basically, I lift the weight up, I hinge, so I push my glutes back, and then I lower myself into the squat. And I find by doing that, I really just allow myself to make sure that I'm focusing on the glutes and that it's less of a quad exercise and more of a glute exercise. And I feel like this is once again a great exercise to do. I only do it once a week because I feel like once a week is necessary because I have other exercises I want to do, but I do it once a week and I like to go quite heavy on it. So pick up a nice heavy dumbbell, elevate yourself, push your hips back, hinge at the hips before you lower down into the squat, lower yourself down slowly, come back up. I like to keep the tension in my glutes so I don't lock out, so I'll come back up and then go straight back down slowly, really pulling. Once again, it's like that RDL movement. You want to really be thinking about your glutes and your hamstrings as you pull yourself up from the squat and keep going. I will do anywhere between like 12 to 15 reps for maybe 4 or 5 sets. When it comes to deciding when to do your exercises, I would definitely encourage you guys to be doing your compound movements first. So on a Monday, which is my glute focus day, I do hip thrusts first, then I do RDLs, then I will do the sumo squats that I've just spoken about. I will do 2 glute isolation or accessory exercises. So I like to pick different ones, not every week, but I like to rotate between kickbacks, hyperextensions, glute abductors, and things like that. So the main glute isolation exercises I do, and the ones that I think are very, very useful, and the one, fair enough, and the ones that I would encourage you guys to do are firstly kickbacks. I love glute kickbacks, and I feel like this is something that I only started putting back into my routine quite recently, and I definitely know and feel like it's something that's helped my glutes just become more. Make sure that before you take your leg out and you kick it back, make sure your leg is slightly abducted and externally rotated. So abducted means away from the body. Take your foot away from your body, and then you want to point your toes a little bit out and then kick back. And by doing that, it allows you to kick back at like this kind of 15 to 30 degree angle. I don't kick my leg directly behind me. I feel like the glute isolation you get from that is just sensational. I love it. We'll do it anywhere for 3 to 4 sets of 10 to 15 reps. It really just depends on how I'm feeling and how heavy I'm going. Glute kickbacks are not exercises that you need to go super heavy on. If anything, I would say drop the weight and just do loads of reps. So sometimes I just go really, really lightweight and I'll just burn out 20 reps. This is important for in terms of training techniques that I'll be explaining, because sometimes fatiguing your muscles and creating that metabolic stress is also good for triggering hypertrophy. So you don't need to be maxing out on glute kickbacks. Rest. it's okay. You can use your cute little 18 kilograms. That's fine. You're still gonna get the glute growth. Next isolation exercise that I absolutely love is the hip abductors. I love this machine. I feel like every single week that I use this machine, I'm always left feeling really sore. The way that I do it is I like to lean forward a bit, and then I like to push my bum as back as I can, lean forward. I don't like to hold on to the machine because I feel like that makes me swing. And I feel like if I'm not holding on, then all the movement is coming straight from my glutes. So I lean forward, I put my hips back, I kind of do this with my hands, and then I abduct outwards. I like doing it as part of a tricep. So what I'll do is I'll put it on like a kind of moderate to heavy weight. I'll do 12 full reps straight into like 8 kind of pulsing or half reps, and then I'll hold it for 5 seconds. Lower the weight in slowly. Don't just slam the weight and allow the machine to bang. Make sure you're controlling the weight and the movement. The next glute isolation exercise I absolutely adore is a single leg RDL. I love a single leg RDL. I think this movement is just so phenomenal. A single leg RDL is just such a great movement. And I love it. I love a single leg RDL. I do it on my glutes and hamstring days. I like to go quite heavy. So I pick up a dumbbell that's anywhere between like 40 and 50 kg. And I'll do 4 sets of 12 reps per leg. If I'm feeling spicy, I'll superset this with some seated hip abductors. But I love this exercise. It's literally just like a normal RDL, but the main difference is that you're doing it with one leg. Some people will like to do B stance RDLs, which is a bit similar, but rather than lifting the leg all the way up, you kind of just have one leg in front of the other, and the leg at the front is the working leg. I prefer single leg RDLs though, but single leg RDLs, B stance RDLs, they're all really the same thing. Some other glute isolation exercises are some step ups. You can also do like a glute focused lunge or Bulgarian split squat. Personally, I don't do step ups or like glute focused Bulgarian split squats. I do Bulgarian split squats, but I do those on my quad days. And I know there's been so much hype on like social media with like, yeah, glute focused Bulgarian split squats and glute focused reverse lunges. I personally just can never really feel my glutes predominantly any lunge movement. So whether that's a reverse lunge, a Bulgarian split squat, a Smith machine lunge, I just can't predominantly feel my glutes. I just always feel those exercises in my quads. So I always do them on a quad day. On quads, I would do deficit lunges. I would do Bulgarian split squats. I would do loads of lunge exercises because that is what works for me. The final thing we're going to look at when it comes to how you train is your training technique. So the way that your muscles actually grow and they get bigger is that when you're exercising or you're putting them under stress or load, the muscle fibers actually break down. And this basically simulates like a whole cascade of events. It's basically like an inflammatory process going on in your body to trigger the body to reproduce and build those muscle fibers back bigger and stronger, basically. So that's what's happening. And there are loads of different things that can trigger this hypertrophy cascade and this hypertrophy process. Obviously, loading your muscles and, you know, putting your load and putting your muscles under a lot of load and tension. But there's different training techniques that can help with that. For example, tension training or creating metabolic stress. So this is the idea of trying to fatigue your muscles. Training technique that I love to use is kind of like finishers. And this is more so just fatiguing your muscles and basically post exhausting your muscles after you've trained them. So sometimes on my glutes days, I like to do like a 100 rep finisher. So I'll pick an exercises and I'll do 100 reps trying to rest as little as possible. So common things I'll do this on is the hip abductor machine. I'll pick like quite a moderate to light weight and I'll just do 100 reps, taking as little breaks as possible. Or I'll do like kettlebell swings or some kind of like low impact, not difficult exercise. And this way you really just fatigue your muscles. And really to this, you can do sets or reps till failure. So you can pick an exercise and you can just say, yeah, I'm gonna just do this exercise until I literally can't go anymore. And also within this is your drop set. So this is where you, you know, start off with a really heavy weight and you do a minimal number of reps and then you drop the weight, do more reps, drop the weight, more reps, drop the weight, more reps. I do like doing this on hip thrust, and sometimes like I say like once a month I would do this where I do like a hip thrust drop set, and that's my main working set of hip thrusts. But I more commonly do this on the hip abductor machine. So I'll start super heavy, do like 6 reps, drop the weight, do 10 reps, drop the weight, do 15 reps, drop the weight, do 20 reps. By the time I'm done, my glutes are finished. Like, my glutes are finished. And to be fair, when it comes to this kind of training, that's the kind of thing that you should only be doing like once a week or once every other week. It's not something you should be doing very often, because you don't want to be putting your muscles under that much tension and that much load. It's really just a training technique to use, you know, quite, you know, here and there, and to push your muscles and really challenge them into that kind of hypertrophy muscle growth area. So guys, that brings us nicely to the end of the video. Really do hope that you will implement the changes that I've mentioned. If you do feel like you need more help or more guidance in the gym, then your girl has got you. Head over to my website. The link will be in the description box below. I have a variety of different workout programs, from gym-based workout programs focused to help you build muscle and gain strength, workout programs that also have gym and home alternatives that are more for people who are trying to shed fat and get lean and things like that. www.lizkerryoday.com. Click on workout guides. Look at which one you feel like would work best for you. If you have any questions, you can just drop me a message on my socials or email me, and I'll be happy to answer them. That is it. Thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in my next one.